and places. Shows me a map of all the places I've taken photographs, so I can pull down one of the pins, push on one of the pins, and see all the photos I took there, see all the photos I took in New York, let's go to Paris, there's all the photos I took in Paris, just tap on it to open them. And in addition to looking at them as we have built-in slideshows. And so I can bring up a slideshow here and select my music and pick one of different transitions. I'm going to pick one called Origami. Let's start a slideshow.
Let's go to YouTube.
I'm going to take a clip of a wet and woofy that I know is in high def on YouTube. And now I can go full screen here. On your landscape. On YouTube. So that's YouTube, and again, here's the related clips and more from that person. And again, whether it's in portrait or landscape, it just all works. And of course, videos from the landscape for this. And we've got movies, TV shows, music videos. It's like going to a TV show like Modern Family, for example, take an episode and watch it. That was a movie. It's Star Trek. And let's go to chapters.
Thank you.
audio and watch video the whole way on one charge. Free night. So we can just set the iPad down and go to sleep automatically. We can come back in the room and still have charge. It's remarkable. Environmentally, the iPads are great too. Arsenic free, bromide flame retardant free, mercury free, PVC free, and its aluminum and glass enclosure is highly recycled. That's a little bit of an overview of the iPod hardware. Now, let's go back to software. We've seen some great built-in applications, all new built-in applications. Now let's talk about third-party applications. Let's talk about the App Store. And to help me do that, I'd like to invite up Scott Forsthoff, our Senior Vice President. Scott.
The App Store has been a huge success. We launched it just about a year and a half ago, and already our customers have downloaded over 3 billion apps, choosing from among the more than 140,000 apps available on the store. Well, we've built the iPad to run virtually every one of these apps unmodified right out of the box. Now, we can do that in 2 ways. We can run these apps with pixel-for-pixel accuracy, black box, in the center of the screen. We can also automatically pixel-double and run those apps full screen. This is really cool. Let me go ahead and show you how it works. So here I have an iPad. We downloaded a number of apps from the App Store. Let me launch just a couple for you. Let's start with Facebook. Here it is. This is the Facebook that you know and love. It just works. I can tap on photos. I can flip to a new photo. And now if you look in the bottom right corner of the screen, there's a button that says 2X. When I tap on it, we automatically scale the application up to full screen. I go back to my news feed. I switch, say, to my profile, to my wall. It all just moves. Now, Facebook uses a lot of text, photos, and some videos. But what about an application that really drives the graphics hardware? What about a game? Let me go ahead and launch a game here. This comes from ESPN, and it's called X Games Snowfront. Now you can see, at the beginning of the game, it plays the video. The video works great on the iPad.